Hello everybody, we are going to discuss a very very important topic today, TQM in education. TQM stands for Total Quality Management in Education, a very interesting topic and an evolving topic. Now think about the word quality. Are we not very sensitive to quality in anything that we produce or we purchase or we consume? Let's say that I want to buy this pen. Am I not very careful whether I purchase the right quality pen? If I want to have food, am I not conscious about the quality of food, the quality of car, the quality of anything and everything? Tell me that product which is so permanent, so critical, in which we cannot afford to make any mistake. A product which is so permanent, so critical, isn't it education? Right? So we are going to discuss total quality. Quality is different. Quality management is different. Quality management is different. Total quality management is different, right? Now quality is not in the product. Of course quality is in the product. More than that, the process of producing this product should ensure that there is quality. Same thing applies to education. Think for a while, is not education a product? Isn't it a service? When you send your children to schools or to college, are you not keen that they should have the quality education? So that is what we are going to discuss in this presentation. So the future total quality in education, let's be very, very clear. We are in a very competitive world. Survival of the fittest. Survival of the fittest. Long ago, Charles Darwin said, it is not the strongest of the species which survives, but the one which is most adaptable to change. Same thing applies to any organization, educational institutions, entity, right? Anything for that matter. So, I want to refer to a very important document everybody is discussing, National Education Policy. In less than a year, we're going to be seeing the implementation of NEP. It's going to be a revolution in this country. India is going to be one of the educational destinations of the world. I quote from the NEP, India will have the highest population of young people over the next decade. And our ability to provide high quality educational opportunities to them will determine the future of our country. Now look at it from this perspective. We're not talking about a scoring of mark in 10th standard or plus 2. We are not talking about whether the children are fluent in English or in their mother tongue or whatever language. We are talking about the future of educational opportunities of our country. A country lives in a global scenario, isn't it? India is part of a global scenario. Ever since 1990s, LPG, liberalization, privatization, globalization started, there is an imperative for every organization, whether it is a company or educational institution or any entity, to be a part of a global market. Very simple. So that brings me to a very interesting thing. What is the goal of education? What is the goal of education? Is it only to produce good engineers or doctors? Or is it to produce good citizens, doctors, lawyers, chartered accountants? If this is the goal of education, we need to look at some of the important quotations. Education is the manifestation of perfection already in a man. It's a quotation from Swami Vivekananda. Next time, when you see a child, look at the curiosity that child displays. Look at the willingness to learn, the eagerness to learn, the restlessness the child goes through to learn. So, it is the manifestation of perfection already existing in man. Swami Vivekananda. Education should also be looking at the kind of human beings to be developed through education. The difference between a good society and not so good society is the quality of human beings. Education is the most powerful means to modify human behavior. 10 years from now, 20 years from now, what type of a society we are going to live? So, of all the people, schools and colleges and educational institutions have the onus of producing quality. Now, we are talking about a world-class school. I am associated with a project of ABS Vidya Mandir of setting up a world-class school. Now, what does it mean? We should understand the needs of the individual teachers. We should understand the needs of the individual child. And we should understand the need for professional development of teachers. Now, this fits into the TQM talk we are talking about. World-class education system. We talk about engaging students in authentic learning experiences, not to drive them to memorize and score marks in an examination, right? A world-class education system actively engages students in their own learning and does not have them to be passive in a classroom. We are talking about thinking beings. We are talking about meaning-making beings in children, right? Now, with this, I'm going to quote a very interesting quotation. Acharyat padamadate. That is, how a child learns. Acharyat padamadate. 1/4 of the education only a teacher teaches. Padam shishya swamedaya. Another 1/4 comes from the inquisitiveness, from the willingness of the child to learn outside the classroom. Padam sab brahmacharibhyaha, which means there are other students in the classroom from whom group discussion we learn. And last but not the least, padam kala kramenacha, which means outside the world, outside the classroom, all the experiences is another teacher. So 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, total we are talking about. In the next segment, we are going to talk about a very interesting topic. UNESCO.
ABS Vidya Mandir, Tiruvallur.